So yeah, Shadow of the Erdtree was worth the wait. We let Miyazaki and FromSoft cook, and they cooked big time. The main question I've seen discussed that most people want an answer to is, how big is the DLC, really? How many hours is it going to take to do everything? Well, to start, this doesn't feel like a DLC. The Shadow Realm is a full-blown expansion, and yes, it's much, much bigger than the size of Limgrave. I figured they were pulling our leg when they said it's around that size, and I guess it essentially is when we're just talking about map size. But the varying heights and depths of the landscapes and the interconnected paths to reach certain areas make it so much bigger than that. I'd say if you were to take each area and lay it flat on the map, connecting them like puzzle pieces, the Shadow Realm is the size of the entire overworld of Elden Ring all the way up to the Erdtree. That's Limgrave, Liurnia, Caelid, Altus Plateau, the City of Leyndell, and Nokron to properly reference the scale of it all. And even then, the Shadow Realm is much more densely packed with things to do and see than all of those areas combined. Just like when I first played Elden Ring, I kept asking myself when it would end, and it would just keep going and going and going. All of those wow moments that I had in the original game were all here in Shadow of the Erdtree. I know it was a long wait, but I honestly think it's impressive that FromSoft developed this in the time frame they did. It really makes sense why it took them almost 2 years to release. It's that big, and it's really that good. $40 feels like a steal for a DLC that could honestly call itself Dark Souls 4. So I hope this video can do it all justice to hype you up even more. We won't be going over everything, and I won't be showing every area to not spoil it for you in this video. I just want to talk about my experience and if it was worth the wait. And I really appreciate FromSoft and Bandai Namco for sending me an early copy so I could experience this game early. If all you needed was to know if it's worth the price of admission, I'd answer that with a resounding yes. Before we get started, I'm happy to say that this video is once again sponsored by War Thunder, a free-to-play vehicular combat multiplayer game across platforms like PC, Xbox Series X, and PlayStation 5. It's even cross-platform compatible with last-gen consoles. There are over 70 million players worldwide with more than 2,500 different vehicles to play with, including tanks, warships, helicopters, and airplanes. The combat is intense, with incredibly detailed vehicles, realistic graphics, and authentic sound effects that place you right at the helm of the most powerful war machines of our time. You can also customize your vehicles with countless camouflages, historical markings, and decorations, including community-created ones. You can sign up for free using the link in the description and the pinned comment. Doing so will get new and returning players that haven't played in 6 months a massive bonus pack across all platforms that includes multiple premium vehicles, the exclusive vehicle decorator Eagle of Valor, 100,000 Silver Lions, and 7 days of a premium account. It's available for a limited time only, so be quick. Thank you, War Thunder, for being a supporter of the channel. So usually when it comes to past FromSoft DLCs, they're always the hardest and best content in those games. Shadow of the Erdtree is no exception to this. Speaking on the difficulty, enemies hit hard and they have a lot of health. There were many moments, especially with every main boss that I came across, that I had to absolutely lock in and focus to have any chance. There is almost no breathing room with any enemy or boss. They are all extremely fast with their own unique movesets that took me a lot of time to get the patterns down. And even then, most of the time, I came out with a win by the skin of my teeth. I don't want to go into too much detail on the bosses, but they are spectacular and unique. There's almost no reused bosses from the main game. There are some, but they're such non-factors compared to the rest of the bosses that it didn't sour my experience whatsoever. There was not a single boss that I didn't enjoy learning the movesets of. I really do feel like FromSoft took the critique that the main game of Elden Ring was too easy to heart. I have almost 2,000 hours in Elden Ring, with thousands of more hours played with all the previous games, and I still struggled at times. So without saying too much more, if you are just looking for a difficult challenge to test yourself, you've definitely got one here. I can't wait for all the challenge runners to put these words to shame, but my first time through the Land of Shadow was a challenge for sure. The key I found was to find as many Skadu fragments as possible, Essentially, these fragments allow you to deal more damage overall, as well as receive less damage from enemies. Most of these fragments can be found at the many different crosses of Mikola that can be found throughout the Shadow Realm. There are other ways to find them as well, but I'll leave that to your curiosity of exploration to figure that out. There are also the revered spirit ashes, which do the same for your spirit summons if you use those. I feel like that's the main theme FromSoft was going for in this expansion. Just like the main game, exploration and going off the main path will reward you. I figured this was going to be the case going in, but they took it to a whole new level here in many different ways. To put it simply, you won't just be rewarded with an item. You could be rewarded with an entire new area with hours upon hours of content to find just because you decided to go around some random corner or jumped onto some random ledge. At the time of recording this video, there are still several areas on the map that I can't find the entrance to. I can see it on the map, but for the life of me so far, I can't figure out how to get there. I hate it, but I also love it. I know it's gonna feel so damn good when I find that random area that I would never think twice about that holds the entrance to a whole new experience. Speaking of areas of interest on the map, the amount of diversity and uniqueness to each legacy dungeon, or even just the open world areas, is absolutely astounding. They're all different, each giving off their own vibe and challenges for the player to adapt to. The level of just pure creativity at work here is just awesome to see in an industry that's becoming increasingly more mundane. FromSoft's ability to work with insane color palettes and their skill with lighting is just on full display here. Just like the main game, there were so many moments where I just had to stop and take a second to take in the beauty of the world I was playing in. They've always focused on art direction over anything else, which I hope more developers look at and understand there are other ways to make a game look and play good without insane graphical fidelity. Not to mention they've packed all of this and compressed the file size down to 16 gigabytes, which is an accomplishment in and of itself. Call of Duty should take notes. I'd also like to mention that I didn't suffer from any frame rate issues at all, which I know was a major gripe when Elden Ring first launched. FromSoft definitely listened to the few critiques the community had with Elden Ring when it first launched. For starters, the Catacomb dungeons have been completely revamped here. A critique of the main game was that these dungeons were too similar to one another, and the rewards you'd get at the end of each weren't usually worth the effort. Here, this isn't the case whatsoever. Each dungeon I found was completely unique to the others, offering various rewards that didn't have to end with a boss room. Most of the time, there was no boss, but a series of puzzles I had to solve by properly exploring the entirety of the dungeon. And the reward was always well worth the effort. Not to mention that these dungeons usually offer plenty of upgrade materials while you're going through it, which upgrading your new weapons work the same as the main game. I would like to suggest that you make sure you have all the bell bearings you need to purchase upgrade materials when you need them. There are a lot of new weapons that you're going to want to test out, so to make it easier before the DLC comes out, load up on those and larval tiers to change your stats so you can wield those weapons. I will say that every weapon I found doesn't scale well with attributes at all, and I believe this was on purpose to entice players to just upgrade the weapons and use them instead of changing your character completely every time you found one. I used mainly a level 170 quality build that had a good amount of levels into everything, but if you want to go big bonk strength build, you absolutely can, along with really anything else. I had fun using all of the weapons I found, so just be ready to upgrade and switch it up a bit depending on what you want to do. Okay, this is the last thing I want to talk about. I know this is mainly a lore channel and I want to talk about it so bad, but this isn't the right time to do it. I don't want to spoil anything, and I feel like I will if I say anything in regards to the lore. Just know that this is an entirely new world, completely separate from the Lands Between. As we already know, you're on a mission to track Mikola throughout the Shadow Realm. Other unique NPC characters that you'll meet are doing the same. It's your quest with these characters to find Mikola. That's really it. There is a lot of new information and aspects of the story here that we have never heard of before. Does this DLC answer any lore questions from the main game? I can't talk about it here just yet. So I'll wait to discuss it with you all once everybody has got their hands on this incredible experience this expansion provides in every aspect. My expectations were through the roof with Shadow of the Erdtree, and after 40 plus hours, I can say that this is well worth the wait. I went into complete degeneracy mode. It's all I've done all day. Gaming, go to sleep. Gaming, go to sleep. Which is not something I've really done since Elden Ring first released. Like I said, there are still several areas, quest lines, and bosses that I haven't found the entrance to yet in that amount of time, 40 plus hours, and there's still much more I need to do. There's plenty of quality content to experience here. This is FromSoft at their very best after already creating their magnum opus with Elden Ring. So that's all I have to say for now. Join our community Discord to discuss with me and our community once the game fully releases. And I'm excited to get back into the Shadow Realm with a brand new build to do it all again and uncover all of the secrets it holds. Shout out again to War Thunder for sponsoring today's video. I really appreciate it. Make sure to check out War Thunder now for free on PC, PlayStation, and Xbox, and use my link in the pinned comment or in the description to register. And of course, those of you who are new or haven't played in 6 months will also receive a massive bonus pack like we talked about, all platforms including multiple premium vehicles, in-game currency, and a whole lot more. Thank you for watching, and good luck in the Land of Shadow, my fellow Tarnished.